I want to talk about three things like that I know you need to hear. I asked people this question and some people didn't like it, but you know me, I'm going to be straight up. I'm going to be real with you because I care about you changing. I care about you making a difference in your life. I care about you elevating. But I asked everybody this question because I asked myself this question. And the question I asked was, why you? And this is not what I'm about to talk about, but this is on my heart. Why you? Like, why should it be you? Because oftentimes we think we deserve it, but we don't put in the work to earn it. We live in a deserved world that everybody thinks they deserve everything. And I believe that you deserve a lot of things in your life, right? But a lot of people don't earn it. A lot of people don't put in the work. And some of us, we giving people titles in our life that they haven't earned, that they don't deserve. That's a whole nother story. But I had to ask myself this question. I asked myself, why me? Like, why me? Why should I be the one? But I asked that question, why should it be you? Like, why should you get the promotion? Why should people follow you? Why should people hire you? Like, why should it be you? And a lot of people don't even know that answer. They think just because, and just because isn't enough. But when you get solid on why it should be you, then that's when it becomes a game changer in your life. All right. So think about that. But I want to share three things. You guys know I talk about perspective a lot. You guys know I talk about this. Like, your perspective can either be your power or your prison. What's a prison perspective? A prison perspective is when you see everything working against you. Right? You blame everybody. You blame everything. You see the world through a negative set of lenses. You see the world as the opposition, right? You see everything working against you. What's a power perspective? You see everything working for you. And so I want to make sure, because I go through these moments in my life too, but I want to make sure that your perspective is building you, not breaking you. I want to make sure that your perspective is helping you, not hindering you. So these are three things, like three simple things that I remind myself. And I've been having to remind myself this often this last 4 months of my life, because I've been going through a very difficult season. You guys know that, probably the hardest season of my life. So I'm having to remind myself of these things because it's very easy. It's very easy for me to see a prison perspective. It's very easy for me to see the negative. It's very easy for me to see depression. It's very easy for me to see things are breaking me, for see things are not going right. So I always have to flip my mindset. And I call these disruptors, right? You need disruptors in your mindset, in your life, that disrupt certain emotions, that disrupt certain trajectories in your life and how you head. Things that remind you, right, of how incredible you are. Things that remind you of how much greatness you have in your life. So let's just stop right there. What are some disruptors? And think about this. I want you to put this to work. What are some disruptors in your life that you have that can instantly snap you back into a power perspective? What are some disruptors? These are things that as soon as you think about it, as soon as you're reminded of it, as soon as you visit it, as soon as you read it, as soon as you hear it, it brings you back to that power perspective. And I've been having to do that lately. Three things that I want to share with you. I want you to remember. Simple stuff, okay? I've said this a lot, right? Life is going to happen. We can't control what life tries to give us. We can't control certain things that happen in our life, right? Sometimes we can, but most times we can't. We can do everything right. 2020 showed us that. We can do everything right. The perfect plans in life can just punch us right in our face. So life is going to happen. And I'm less concerned about life happening, and I'm more concerned about these three things, okay? Number one, life is not about what happens to you, but it's about the meaning you give to what happens to you. So you heard me talk about this before, right? Some of us, we don't have powerful meanings in our life. That's why we don't walk in power. People who go through the most and you still see them persevere, you still see them have emotional resilience, you still see them find a way out of no way, you still see them break through when they feel like they're breaking down. They have developed a meaning, right? A meaning for the situation, a meaning for the storm. Right? The storm has a meaning. The storm, you can say the storm is flooding my life and causing me to drown. Or you can say, you know what? The storm is producing growth in my life. It might be uncomfortable, but I know the storm is producing growth. Because last time I checked, a garden can't grow without rain. Last time I checked, there's no rainbow without the rain. So what meanings are you giving to situations? And you got to like premeditate these meanings. Because when life hits you blindfolded, when life throws you a curveball, you got to be ready for it. Because some of us, we live in reaction mode where we're trying to react. But I know people who really make a difference, people who really don't get off track that much, they pre-plan and they know exactly how they're going to, they know exactly the meanings they're going to give things. So remember, number one, write this down. Life is not about what happens to you. It's about the meaning you give to what happens to you. Number one, life is not about what happens to you. It's about the meaning you give to what happens to you. Number two, okay, we're going to stick on this theme about life is not about. Number two, life is not about what happens to you, but it's about how you respond to what happens to you. And I'm about to get fired up right now. I'm about to get fired up right now. Because listen, we can't control a lot, But we can control how we respond. We can control. We might not control what life tries to give us, but we sure can control how we respond. So my question to you right now, and I want you to premeditate this and think about this. How you going to respond, right, when things go the wrong way? How you going to respond when people turn their back on you? How you going to respond, right, when you're not getting the support? How you going to respond when that business plan doesn't work out? How you going to respond? How you going to respond when you hit rock bottom? You going to respond with power? You going to respond with perseverance? Are you going to respond with blame? Are you going to respond with self-pity? How you going to respond? You got to make up that in your mind right now. Because me, I'm going to respond with greatness. Even if greatness looks like me crawling, even if greatness looks like me barely making it, even if greatness looks like me, you know, just on my knees praying to God every single night because that's the true greatness, I'm going to respond. I said, you can sink or you can swim. I told myself that. And sometimes in life, like I said, the problems that come into your life aren't meant to drown you. They're there to teach you how to swim. The problems that flood in your life aren't meant to drown you. They're there to teach you how to swim. But some of us, when we drown in these problems, because we already made up in our mind how we're going to respond. Are you going to sink or are you going to swim? You're going to sink in fear? You're going to sink in blame? You're going to sink in the prison perspective? Or are you going to swim? Sometimes it's all you can swim with is faith. You don't know how you're going to make it out the struggle. You don't know how you're going to make it out the mud. You don't know how you're going to make it out of it, but you know you're going to make it out of it because God got you. I've been there. I've been there. And it's faith that carries me through. It's faith that I hold on to when times get hard. I don't have enough strength to be able to do it myself, but I lean on God for my strength. So how you going to respond? You going to sink or you going to swim? What's it going to be? Because this is just life, and I get it. Life ain't fair. Life sucks. I understand all of that stuff. But at the end of the day, ain't nobody going to keep feeling sorry for you. Life is just going to keep going on. I know this might seem insensitive, but trust me, it happened. When I lost football and I was depressed, wasn't nobody checking for me after about 3 months? Wasn't nobody calling my phone asking me I'm all right? Because life went on. And I don't hold any grudges to people against that because I understand that. Life goes on. And so you either can sit in depression or you can deal with your depression, do something with it, and grow from your depression. Okay, so life is not about what happens to you. It's about how you respond to what happens to you. When you find a reason to, oh man. All right. When you find a meaning, and maybe I'm just feeling this. Maybe y'all like, Trent, I ain't feeling what you're saying, but I'm feeling it. When you find the meaning to swim, when you find the reason, right, to respond a certain type of way, when you realize that certain people are dependent on you, when you realize how big your mission is, when you realize the bigger picture, you will find a way to swim. I promise you, you will find a way. When these floods happen, because they're going to come. When these tsunamis happen, because they're going to come. When these hurricanes happen in our life, because they're going to come. When these storms that come out of nowhere are going to happen, these tornadoes, all these terrible storms happen, they're going to come. But you got to be the meteorologist in your life. You got to know when these storms come, you prepare for it. You know exactly what you're going to do. You know where your shelter is. Whew. You know where your shelter is, right? You know where your safe haven is. You know the mindset that you're going to turn to. You know how you're going to respond. You know how you're going to bounce back. You know how you're going to grow. You know where your focus is. Your focus is. Your focus is. Because sometimes what we do is we stay in a storm. I'll tell you a story. Some of you heard me tell the story before I move on. I'll tell you the story really quick. So God bless my grandmother's soul. She's no longer here. We were actually leaving her funeral. We're leaving her funeral and we're driving back from Little Rock, Arkansas. Shout out to all my people in Little Rock. That's where I was born. My family is born. Shout out to my Little Rock, Arkansas people. A lot of people don't know that. But we're driving back from Little Rock, Arkansas, back to Fort Worth, Texas, right? And I saw on the radar there was a bad storm. Terrible storm. I'm talking about like Wizard of Oz storm. You know when the Wicked Witch and Dorothy got swept up in a tornado storm? I'm talking about a storm like that. Like it was bad. It was terrible. I'm talking about you can't even see in front of you storm at all. You driving like this, right? And I'm like nervous, but I got to be, you know, I got to be, act like I got my composure together. I can't let Maria and the kids know I was nervous, right? It was dangerous. So I check my phone and I see where the storm is, like a tornado or something coming. And I see it and I saw it was passing. So my dad is following me, right? My dad calls and says, hey, we going to stop. And I'm like, man, I'm not stopping. I said, I'm gonna just keep going because the weather app showed me that if I kept driving, I would be out of the storm. In just a few, I would be out of the storm in like 10 minutes if I kept driving. So I said, I'm going to just drive strong. I'm going to take my time, but I'm not sitting in the storm, because if you sit here, you're going to be in the storm for a long time because how the storm was moving. My dad sat there, right? So I made the decision to keep driving. And I kid you not, this is life. When you make a decision, oftentimes that's the right decision, it feels like the wrong one, because things start to go wrong. Things start to come against you. Oppositions start to work against you in your life and against your progression. And so as soon as I made this decision, I'm talking about hell. I'm talking about a storm, like a storm. It was bad. I'm like, dang, I should listen to my dad. Like, I'm nervous at that point. But I said, you know what? I'm going to trust the weather app. The weather app said if I kept driving through the storm, I would get through it. And I kept driving, right? And as I kept driving, the storm lightened up. The storm got less and less worse. The rain started to light up. I started to see the road in front of me, the cars in front of me. It was that bad. And eventually, within 10 or so minutes, I got out of the storm. My dad stayed in the storm. They were in that storm for an extra hour because they sat there. Some of us, the point I'm trying to make is this. Some of us, we're staying stuck in our storm because we're not trusting the GPS. We're not trusting what God has said for our life, that if we keep going, if we keep driving through our storm, if we keep progressing through our storm, this storm will soon end. But some of us, we're so afraid to do it that we stay, just like my dad did. He was smart, but they got hit hard. He was scared. He's like, I think the tornado is right over us. But he stayed in the storm, which I understand that too. But some of us, we're choosing to stay in a storm that we're no longer supposed to be in because we're so afraid, because we don't know how we're going to respond. I had made up in my mind that I was going to keep driving because I wanted to get home. Okay? So think about that, okay? So number two, life is not about what happens to you, but it's about how you respond to what happens to you. Number three, this is major. Life is not about what happens to you. It's about how you use what happens to you. If you want to take the power out of something that's making you feel powerless, if you want to take the power out of that bad situation that happened to you in your past, if you want to take the power out of that loss, if you want to take the power out of that setback, if you want to take the power out of that rejection, if you want to take the power out of someone leaving your life, if you want to take the power out of that mistake, if you want to take the power out of anything that didn't help your life, use that to help your life. I'm a walking testimony of doing that. The thing that was supposed to break me, I took those broken pieces and I built, with God's help, a masterpiece of purpose in my life. Because I use what happened to me. And one of the best ways to get power from a situation that made you feel powerless is to use that. You went through it. You went through the pain. Don't just go through the pain for no reason. Get some out of it, right? Don't just go through the season for no reason. Get some out of it. Don't just go through the time for no reason. Get some out of it. Don't just go through the situation for no reason. Get some out of it, right? Let that thing make you stronger. Let that thing make you better. Let that thing teach you. Let that thing grow you. Because me, I'm not a product of perfection. I'm not a product of excellence. I'm not a product of none of those things. What I am a product of, I'm a product of my past. And the reason I said this is because I learned how to use my past to build a great future for my life. I took those things and say, you know what? I'm going to use this. If I'm going to go through it, I'm going to grow through it. If I'm going to go through it, I'm going to get something out of it. That's facts. Some of us, we going through things for no reason. Some of y'all got incredible stories that you went through. And you just went through the story and you just tell your story with no intention of actually using it to better your life and better other people's lives. Some of y'all got some incredible things that you've been through, and you just keep those things as things that you've been through, things that you're currently still dealing with, instead of things that you grew from, instead of things that you use to create something better for your life. You better use those things that were trying to use you. You better take those broken pieces and take those broken pieces and build a masterpiece in your life. Use it. Life ain't about what happens to you. It's about how you respond. It's about the meaning. It's about how you use it. Some of the worst things in my life that happened to me turned out to be the greatest tools for my life. Some of the worst things that I went through created the greatest tools for my life. to help other people get through their situation. I decided not to surrender to those things. Some of y'all surrendering to those things, right? Some of y'all surrendering to those things. Surrender to your purpose, man. Surrender to the plan that God has for your life, man. Stop surrendering to your pain. Stop surrendering to your depression. Stop surrendering to your past. Some of us, we surrender into the wrong things. We surrender to it. Make that thing surrender to you. Some of y'all allow your past to own you. Don't own your past. You better let your past know that you a beast. You better let your past know that you a warrior, that you more than a conqueror. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Let's stop sleeping on our life, man. Some of y'all been pressing snooze too much on your life and you counted yourself out. You better start counting on yourself. Stop counting yourself out because people counted you out. Stop counting yourself out because you feel like you're too old that, oh, my dreams can't come true because of this, because of the mistakes that I made. Maybe your dreams didn't come true because God had something better for your life. Did you think about that? Maybe people have to leave your life because God has something better for your life. Did you think about that? Some things have to fail so God's purpose for your life could prevail. Did you think about that? Yeah. I'm talking to you, and I know it's tough. I know some of you lost loved ones. I get it. I know it's tough. But I tell you right now, with my mom's situation, I know what my mom would want. I know what my grandparents that left this earth would want. And I refuse to surrender to anything that's trying to break me. I'm going to allow all those things to build me, all those things to make the purpose greater, the mission even stronger. I'm going to go hard. And I know everybody got a mindset like me. I'm not telling you to think like me. But you got a life. And your life ain't meant to be wasted. I understand everything you've been through. I understand what you're going through. I get it. I know it sucks. I know it hurts. I know it's not fair. But what are you going to do about it? You going to use it? Or are you going to let that thing use you for the rest of your life? Right? Get something out of it. Let that thing make you better. So when you tell your story, you can say, because of this, I became this. Yeah. Because of this, that thing that I was praying to release so much in my life, the thing that broke me so much, the thing that led to depression, the thing that made me so sad, because of this, created so much joy in my life. Because of that. If it wasn't for that, if it wasn't for the imperfect season, I wouldn't be living the perfect purpose for my life. Hello. Hello. If it wasn't for the imperfect season, I wouldn't be living the perfect purpose for my life. If it wasn't for the things that I lost, I wouldn't have gained so much for my life. Sometimes the best way God adds to your life is to subtract from it. God has a funny way of doing things. Man, this is not the end of your story. It's a chapter, bro. It's a chapter, a chapter, a chapter. Turn the page. Trent, I've had so many bad chapters. Every time I turn the page, it's another page of pain. It's another page of setbacks. I'm tired of turning the page. Well, what you going to do? You're going to stay in a situation that you know is not going to change, or you're going to take a chance to make a change? I'm going to take a chance every single day. I don't care if the next 10 pages look like this page. I have faith that maybe the 11th page will be different. Maybe the 12th page will be different. Maybe the 13th page will be different. Maybe next year will be different. Maybe 2 years from now will be different. That's what faith is called, my friend, is when you know that something better is going to happen for your life, even if you can't see it happening. That's what faith is called, my friend. You know what faith is called? When you can't see it growing, but you know growth is taking place. That's what faith is called, my friend. When people count you out, but you're still counting yourself, that's what faith is called, my friend. When all these impossibilities flood your life, but you still see the possibility, that's what faith is called, my friend. That's what faith is called, my friend. That's all I'm going to say tonight, man. That's all I'm going to say. And this is, I hope that y'all get this, because every time I come on here, I am pouring from the heart because I care. I want you guys to break through and get this, man. I'm going to say this. You know what's funny? So 2 nights ago, I literally was binge watching my own videos. I was binge watching my own videos. Yes, me. And it, I don't know, arrogant stuff. Or I needed to hear me. I did. I clicked on one video. I was like, dang. I didn't remember me saying that. Like, I'm not going to remember me talking today. I'm literally letting God flow through me. Like, I'm not. Y'all got to send me notes. But I looked. I was like, dang, I need to hear that. Dang, I need to be reminded of that. Dang, I looked at myself. I was like, man, I had so much joy when I made that video. I could tell, man, I need to get back to that person. Right? So sometimes you got to remind you of you. Sometimes y'all looking out for inspiration, but you need to look in the mirror and find your inspiration. Or you need to go back to a picture, go back to a moment. And I had to listen to me. I literally watched my videos for an hour. And I was like, dang. And then I spoke to myself, man. So I wanted to share that with y'all. Let's get it.